What's up, cave dwellers? I'm Gabe, not Flash today.
I'm the Drifter. Welcome to Gambit Prime.
Ding. Time to defeat the darkness.
Ding. Why are we here today, Gabe?
Well, we got a box.
No. We're here to thank our sponsors.
Ah, he's right.
Make sure you check them out if you're looking for a new career. You're looking to be built because they build people, change lives. Gabe here just was built. His life has changed now. This box is going to change your life. Thank you, RPG, for allowing us to do pink box stuff here. Absolutely.
We got a box.
Gabe, why are we actually here?
We got a box.
You should say it like seven times.
Yes, we got a box. We got a box.
We have this really big box here. Obviously, it stands taller than the table.
We're standing. You know what that means for
it's
the
me on my knee next to it. So it's a big box. Gabe, yeah. Let's lift this big box on the thing, and we will show everybody what it is.
You guys know every time we have a box and we're standing.
I know.
It's a statue.
It's the big box show, and I'm sure with the title,
we love boxes.
The title of the video, they knew what it was anyways.
What's in the box?
Me. Anyways.
It's a Gambit maquette, whatever
we
it is.
We have here today a Sideshow Gambit maquette. This thing is an awesome piece. It is a part of the Danger Room series.
Yeah.
The X-Men Danger Room series, along with Rogue, Colossus, and the Juggernaut.
Which I think all of them have some kind of weapon that's emerging from the floor.
Yeah, it's like coming out of the floor, and that's part of it.
Rogue has a saw blade, I know, and then he has
he's got a claw.
Claw, yeah.
So we're going to unbox and build this and go over it and do a review today. This piece is really awesome. Hopefully everybody has seen this before. If not, we are glad we can show it to you for the first time. We'll start off with a little bit of dimensions here inside, let's do dimensions later. Let's do dimensions whenever we get it out so people can kind of get a judge for it. We'll go ahead and take it out of the box, though.
All right. I don't remember the name of the comic now.
All right.
I feel bad for not knowing the name of the comic. Well.
First, this one is only two layers, unlike some of the other ones that are three and a bunch of different stuff. So it all kind of fits here like this. So I guess let's take some of this stuff out of packaging and have it all sitting here. All right. So as you can see here, there's not a lot of parts to this one.
Compared to the rest,
there's not a lot of parts because the other ones had a bunch of pieces, you know, three layers here. But all the parts are very good detailed. A lot of detail on them. And a lot of really neat stuff here.
I love the detail on the floor.
Absolutely. Let's show this right here. So there's a lot of detail on this floor here that goes in and even the underside. I love the color combo here.
We got number 34.
Oh, number 34 of 4,000. Wow. Maybe you can see that there, Brandon.
It's pretty cool.
Yeah. Let's move this stuff out of the way here, and then we will go ahead and build him. Let me get him set up here.
We're just taking pieces out.
I guess we should just sit this on the floor and just pick the pieces up.
Yeah.
We don't want to scratch them up. Set the base down there, yeah? We're a little build going here.
It starts with the claw, which goes in one of these ways.
It goes in. Let's just say that. We don't know how, but it does.
There we go.
You sure?
One hour later.
It'll be fine.
Not if it falls over.
Yeah, it won't. Have a little faith. No. It goes that way because it balances out by going across the platform.
All right, well, I guess it's in there. I just don't trust it. We'll start off with him. Suppose he goes in right there. Do you trust that, Brandon? I don't trust that, man. Yeah, I'm gonna have to. There's something not going on here, right? Yeah. Wow, never had trouble with these things like this. All right. He's there.
The pieces just not want to fit together?
No. I don't know if that's all the way in or what.
Yeah.
So I guess there was two different editions of it. One that was, he had the different head, right?
Yeah. Oh. So we don't have that one, do we?
Mm-mm.
That goes in there.
He's not going to go together right. There he goes. Okay, there we go. There we go. All right.
Explosions. Does that go there? Yep.
Mm-hmm.
Just go there.
Somewhere. Oh, right. Right there. Yeah. Oh. That's wild.
Oh, okay. There we go.
There we go. Okay, cool. This staff.
Always has his bow staff.
Oh, there you go. After some technical difficulties, we finally have this gigantic statue here together. What a beautiful piece. That's all I can say. It's awesome.
Love the detail. It's great.
Lots of detail, even from the base all the way up his...
Like all the way up to just the wave, the card wave.
Yeah, it's awesome. I mean, look at it.
Like the backs of the cards have the X-Men's symbol. That's
absolutely
awesome.
You know, here, let me just pull his hand off right here. Maybe...
Just don't break the wave.
Yeah, I don't want to find it. Brandon, can you see that with your... Yeah, so, I mean, tons of detail here. I love the way they've got him sitting. Oh, jeez. Like, I like these statues, Gabe, but I hate them because they're so hard to put together and they're just so finicky. Not, like, hard. Like, you saw me putting together a giant Lego Millennium Falcon, but, like,
yeah.
These things, I don't want to break them. Like, at least with Legos, you can just throw them down and pick it back up.
Yeah, but like, they're meant to be.
Yeah, lots of detail here. I've watched some other videos where some of them said something about the wave here looks plasticky. I don't think so. I think it's got good detail. I mean, even between here, it looks...
Like, it looks good. I love the translucency. A lot of people don't for some reason. I think that works perfectly for energy.
The cards...
Should look clear.
Yeah, the cards look great. Good detail on them. They've got like a pink hue to them just to go with the wave. I love the way that they've got him sitting up here. I mean, this is a big statue. I mean, look how big he is, you know, like, from end to end here.
The purpley-pink accents on his legs... make it pop perfectly. The greaves that he has look awesome. The detail on those.
For sure. And like I was saying, big statue, and they've got him held up by this one point here, which is, you know, it's a lot of weight to go like this, and it's cool to see him like that. A lot of them, like you see the Galactus back here, he's just standing up. And like the Spider-Man, they got him in this good, cool action scene. I like it how both his feet are not connected, and it's like he's, you know, mid-go, and he's got his staff. The jacket's got a lot of good detail, a lot of good paint work.
The grip, you can see where it's gripped on, or where there's like...
It's knurled.
Yeah, on the handle, the staff. On the grip of the staff. And it looks like it would actually, you know, close up and extend.
Mm-hmm. Good like detail the on the bottom of the danger room floor here.
The shatter, everything's uneven, where it's shattered on the floor, where all the panes are, the tile... Even this is like sticking up. There's pieces, small little like tiny pieces, just sticking up where it's like already been thrown back.
For sure. And if you're looking for a piece to add to your collection, and if you've got any of the other X-Men pieces from the Danger Room set, I 100% say go ahead and do this one too, just for the fact of the cool action scene is going, the awesome colors, the great craftsmanship, the paint, everything is just it's there. It's money. And I don't know. I thought they were all the same, and maybe we missed something over here. I don't think so. I thought they were all the same, but apparently there's like a limited edition one.
That has a special head where he's got his hair's down. It's like matted.
He's got the toothpick in his mouth.
Matted down. He's got his toothpick in his mouth. And it looks...
I would recommend if you're going to get one, go ahead and get the other one, because me personally, I like the
yeah.
face. And
it
the
looks
head
better.
Of the other one. It's going to look great next to all these other ones, and eventually when we move, we'll have an even cooler whole setup of all the statues. So
yeah,
I'm definitely looking forward to adding this one to it. Maybe we'll get
We'll
like...
say the outside of the claw, there's... Of course, not a ton of detail, but the inside of it, you can see all the gears and mechanism and the center of it. It looks just amazing.
It's a good-looking piece.
Yes.
It really is a good-looking piece. And Gabe, tell them about who made it and all that stuff. I'm going to grab a tape measure. Maybe we can measure it out a little bit.
So the artists were, I think the main artist was Will Harbottle, which he did the sculpt and design. Richard, I don't know how to say his last name, Luong. He did some of the design too. Adam Smith worked on the mold and the cast of it, which was casting the polyresin and everything and working on the mold for the polyresin. And then Kate Sapina, I'm hoping I'm saying that right, she did the painting, which phenomenal painting job with all of that, sculpting too. And then the Sideshow design and development team, of course, worked on the mass production and development of all of it. Materials, it is a polyresin, which a lot of statues are along, it's not including, you know, paint and everything, but, and then the height of this beautiful thing is 22 inches, and that is 558.8 millimeters for, you know,
wow.
Across the pond.
I didn't have to go grab it. Good thing I couldn't find one anyways. Gabe actually knew the height and stuff already. Go ahead and...
Width of it is, which I'm assuming is this, is 26.4 inches or 670.56 millimeters.
Which would be from just the tip of his jacket to the tip of the card, I assume, is about 26 inches.
I'd assume the height is from the base to the tip of the wave, which is the highest point.
Which is, what, 22 inches?
Yes. And it weighs about 27.6 pounds, or
I can tell. We picked this thing up a minute ago and put it on the,
kilograms.
The Lazy Susan here, and it's a heavy piece. Not quite as heavy as the Punisher. I think that one is all just in the base, but...
Yeah. No, it's also in the motorcycle, too.
You're right, yeah.
Motorcycle's pretty heavy, too.
It's an awesome piece. It really is.
It really is. I think the wave is cool. I know there are some others that have done the wave, like the Sideshow, or no, I'm sorry, the Sideshow. XM did a wave, and I think there was another company that did a wave, and a lot of people are like, oh, it's just copying. But I like they have it at a different angle. I like the translucent, because most of them have it not translucent. They have it dark.
Well, see, we obviously we haven't gotten the XM yet.
No,
I'm not saying we're going to, but we have not gotten it. But the XM is weird because he's more standing upright and he's throwing his cards underhand like this, which is cool too.
It's cool, but this is an entirely different angle. The cards look different.
Yeah, full wave, full, like, you know, action scene, jumping through the claw.
And of course, they have all of theirs is a bit more grittier, it looks like. So it's more like the original appearance, the original full appearance. The trench coat is darker on that one, and then the brighter, it's not as brighter colors, which I will say I do like the brighter colors on this one more.
Yeah.
I like it. I like him to be, you know, hot purple, hot pink almost.
Hot purple.
Yeah.
That's a new one.
Hot purple.
I know hot pink, but hot purple.
Yeah, I'm going to call that hot purple because it's kind of a mixture.
Yeah, it's like
it's a bit brighter than magenta, I'd say.
It's an odd color.
It's a cool color.
It's a cool color.
It works. He's even got stubble on his face, which is pretty cool that they have that detail.
Yeah, they do know that. That's neat.
Neat.
Fantastic.
The thing with the other head, though, is it doesn't look as much like he's in action because the hair is...
This one's like angry straight face.
This is him literally in action. The other one's got him, like, he's, like, smirking. He's got a toothpick in his mouth, and the hair is down.
Yeah, this one's like, you know, he's... like full on giving it his all. The other one's like, I'm completely in control.
I don't care.
Three cards.
He's just like, I don't care.
Yeah.
Either way, it's a great piece. It's awesome.
Did you talk about the artist or anything yet?
Yes.
Okay.
Yeah.
While I walked out to get the tape measure?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. Well, cool. Super awesome piece. And if you are into collecting these, remember that this does come with three other ones as far as I'm aware of, which is Rogue, Colossus, and Juggernaut in the Danger Room base. I think we should take a vote on which one we get next. Gabe, which one do you think we should get? I'm saying Colossus. I haven't even seen
it. Oh, from this series?
Yeah, I haven't even seen it. I didn't really like Rogue.
I want Juggernaut.
Have you seen it?
No.
All right, we just randomly buy one.
I've seen Rogue. We both seen Rogue.
We did see Rogue.
She's all right. I'm not going to say she's bad. She's all right.
I don't like her suit. I like Rogue, but I don't like Rogue's suit in the set, but...
But, you know, if you have Gambit, you kind of need Rogue because they go together.
Do they?
Yeah. They're a thing at one point in the comics, you know.
I gotcha.
And after they kind of split up, then that was what most people consider to be the death of Gambit. They tried to have a spinoff series after that and it didn't work out ever. So, either way.
Well, Gabe, I'll scoot this over here. And let's talk about Gambit himself just a little bit because we do...
have his first full appearance, not his cameo appearance, which was Uncanny X-Men 265, but this is 266, which is where he full appeared. So what was going on in this comic when he first appeared, they didn't have an origin yet, which that didn't come out until, like, I think 2009.
So this is his first appearance, full appearance, but there's no origin.
No.
It's just, hi, this is Gambit. Which is kind of weird because he literally just comes in and saves Storm.
Yeah, he was stealing from a building that got, like, a wall blown out of it or something, and Storm's just like, I'm running for my life, because she didn't have her powers. I don't remember why, but she didn't have her powers at the time, and she was running from I don't remember who, also. But Gambit saves her, saves the day, and then she's like, come be part of the X-Men.
But how was she part of the X-Men if she didn't have her powers?
Oh, no. She had her powers. They were taken away from her.
Oh, so somehow.
Like, she lost her powers.
Someone finessed her powers, is what you're saying.
Yeah, something like that. Like, she lost her powers at some point. But,
so,
it's pretty cool. He was a lot grittier in this, but he also wore the bright colors. In fact, I'd say those are brighter than that statue, and it's cool. But he looks a lot more grittier than he does later.
With that being said, Gabe, tell us a little bit about Gambit himself.
What do you mean? He's the Raging Cajun.
Yeah, well, a little bit more about Gambit, because most people only know him as a pink card-throwing, trench coat-wearing guy.
So, when he first came out, they didn't have an origin, of course.
So, what are his real powers?
So, it's not throwing cards, although that is, like, it's his gimmick. It's a gimmick. That's all it is. His whole thing is he's a gimmick. So, he's a thief, of course, and his whole power is he can imbue things with kinetic energy. So, anything at all. Like, his fist, items, bolts. He threw nuts and bolts at one point.
That head that just flew across the screen?
Yeah. He threw nuts and bolts at one point. He's imbued his staff to hit somebody harder. He has really good, like, acrobatics, but he's never been trained in that. Apparently, one point in the comics, he's apparently one of the best hand-to-hand fighters, not because of his powers, because he knows French kickboxing, which I don't know the difference between that and English kickboxing, but
did they fight?
Nick Fury commented that he was like the best hand-to-hand fighter that he knows, so which is pretty cool, you know, coming from Nick Fury.
Yeah, yeah. He also at one point became too powerful and literally became Dr. Manhattan.
He became God.
He became Dr. Manhattan. And
so sad, Steve Jobs.
Yeah, he something about Steve Jobs.
Yeah.
Anyways, there was a real comic line where he looked like Dr. Manhattan.
Yeah, literally, like he turned himself into pure energy. That was Sun something.
New Sun.
New Sun, yeah, something like that. I'm pretty sure.
Brandon, either way, playing Call of Duty Mobile. This is not a ad. I really think Brandon's over in the corner playing it.
Yeah, that's not a bit. He's been playing it a lot.
Wish we had ads. That'd be cool.
Anyways, Dr. Disrespect wants to be him.
So yeah, super cool statue here. A little bit of information about Gambit himself. If you're not familiar with him, other than he throws cards with pink energy waves, you should probably look into it. We did. I can now say I like Gambit a lot more than I did before because I genuinely just didn't know about Gambit.
We'll say I think Gambit is lame in the fact that he doesn't use his powers to the full potential. I know he can't because they were limited at one point in the comics. That's why New Sun exists, because it's him with his full power and potential, but the fact that he just uses the gimmick for stuff, it's kind of lame, I think. Why use cards when you can, you know, throw swords? It may be a bit gory, but, you know, it's cool.
And the cards are pretty neat. If it fits his personality. I mean, he's a casino, raging Cajun. He's a con man. You know.
Yeah, he's a thief. That's why he does cards.
He's a magician. You know, the cards are just for show.
Cardistry. Cardistry.
I like it.
It's cool.
I like the cards.
Yeah.
Well, hopefully everybody liked the statue build here. Our review, which was us rambling about how we actually liked the statue. I don't know of anything wrong with it, honestly. I really like...
A bit wobbly. That's about it.
Yeah, it's a bit wobbly. If you're building it, do be careful. Maybe it's just ours, but this base...
Also, spikes are fragile. Don't break them.
This base is a little wobbly, which is not right now, actually. I think his weight countered it, but...
Yeah.
It's a little wobbly, so be careful with it.
We'll say things to look at. Cards. They actually have detail on the back of cards. I think that's cool.
It makes me want to, like, pull one out.
Yeah.
No, I can't, but it makes me want to. And as always with a Sideshow piece and XM pieces or any of these bigger pieces, these quarter scale pieces, be careful because of the tips of these little things here, the little explosions or the cards may break. So
we got to make sure not to do that when we move.
Yeah. Yeah.
But that goes for all the statues.
Hopefully you enjoyed the little bit we did here with the Gambit piece. Let's show him again with next to the box. Pretty big box. Pretty big statue.
22 inches.
22 inches. Box is definitely larger than 22 inches.
He's definitely a wide and tall statue, so you gotta have space. He won't fit in like one of those IKEA shelf squares, I don't think.
No, he's definitely not going to. Like the ones behind us?
Yeah.
No, definitely not going to.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But that's good. It's cool.
Alright, well, Gabe.
This was our review on the Raging Cajun statue.
I think we should move on to some giveaways. And as always, it is time to give away some cards, and right now we are about to give away Benny Thompson's cards from last week's show. These are some awesome cards. I don't know which camera you can see them better off of. Maybe this one, maybe this one. I don't know. Let's see if I can get these out here. Awesome cards.
Great.
Good stuff.
You did great, Benny.
Yes, you did, buddy.
You did great.
Sick cards. Awesome interview as well. I really like doing an interview with him. So let's give them away.
That was a good interview.
Okay, find us a winner. This is the cue where you smash your head on the table. Congratulations to the winners. We hope you love them. All of the winners here, right here, and the loot box winner as well. We will get these mailed out to you. Thank you for entering, and make sure you enter for this week as well, because we have an awesome interview and artist now as well. I said as well like four times. As well, as well, as well, as well. Welcome to this week's Meet the Artist. I am here this week with Gerry Garcia Jr. He's Hello. An awesome artist, and welcome, Gerry.
Thank you. How are you?
I'm good. How are you?
Not too bad.
Not too bad. That's good to hear. It would be I would hate for you to say I'm not doing too good. That would not be fun. We would have questions.
Right. But, right.
Before we get started here, I have a super important first question for you. Who would win in a street fight, a taco or a grilled cheese?
Taco. They have more spice.
Taco, they have more spice. I need to go back to all the ones I've done and like take tally. I need to know, because this is a question to ask everybody. I need to know who would win based off of popular vote. And I think the taco is winning right now. I think only one person said grilled cheese. I don't remember what their reasoning was.
So. But there's also, you know, they have legs because they have a walking taco. Did you ever hear that?
I haven't.
Yeah. It's like something you get at sporting events, high school sports or something like that. They call it a walking taco. That was just a bad joke. Sorry.
I got you. I'm lost. I will forever be lost on that one. I have to Google it later.
Yeah,
I don't know. That one went right over my head. I don't know why. Have you ever seen the movie Hot Rod? This is not part of my questions, but have you ever seen the movie Hot Rod? With Andy Samberg?
No.
Because nobody's gotten the question yet what it's off of. Someone might eventually, but that's what I got that off of. If you haven't seen Hot Rod, it's like one of those stupid movies that's really funny.
But, I may have caught a couple bits of it, but never sat through.
He wants to be like a stuntman?
Yeah.
Yeah, that was like a question in the movie, like randomly, and I've always thought it was funny. So, all right, we'll go on to a real question here. How did you get into art?
I've been drawing since I was 5 years old. So my father was a practicing artist, went to school for it, and kind of just allowed for the corporate world to take over, and he kind of lost interest. But before he did that, he kind of sat me down and sit down and show me some, you know, drawings that he did in the past and kind of say, here, try and see if you can draw. Basically, a lot of the cartoon type things, stuff that he and I would practice over. So, yeah, at a very early age, I started with pencils, as most normal kids, and crayons, whatever was round, coloring books, whatever. But yeah, that's how I got started, and you know, I've been doing it ever since. And lately, professionally, with licensed companies since 2000. Check that, 2015
is what you see. Yeah, cool. Mm-hmm. So, the next question was actually, how long have you been doing? But you just answered that one, so I'll go into the next one or a different one. Okay. What's your favorite medium you use?
It's always been acrylic.
Acrylic. So you do a lot of paints.
Yeah. Because I feel I can get the most realistic. I've always been more of a realist.
Mm-hmm.
I feel I can get more out of that, more than markers or color pencils. To get it the most realistic I can, it's through acrylic.
So with the ones that you did for us, are most of these acrylic then, or are they all acrylic?
They are a little bit of everything. I tried to do the pencil work, a bit of marker work, colored pencil, and the ones that you see the most detail in are the acrylic.
Okay. That's good to know. We'll go through some here in just a minute.
Sure.
I do have another question for you first, though. What is your favorite piece you've ever done?
It would have to be my Topps Galaxy base card art.
Topps Galaxy base card art.
Yep.
So for the Galaxy set, which do you have?
It was from the 2000 set, and it was a Luke Skywalker piece, and I really wish I had that with me around here. I just moved, so things are kind of, you know, in boxes still, but yeah, if you look it up, you know, you'll see my name, and Luke Skywalker's Journey is the card.
I'll have to 46. Look that up. We may, if Chris can work his magic, he can pop it up here so we can, everybody can see. Because people tell us all the time, you know, what their favorite piece is, but we don't actually have anything to show. But now that that's an official piece that we can Google, hopefully, that would be cool to have on the screen. So awesome, awesome. Well, we will, let's talk about some of these cards here before we go on. And we'll start off with ourselves. Hopefully it's not going to be blurry like it was 20 minutes ago. Is it blurry?
Can you see that?
Or is it's like super white, bright? Okay. Hopefully you can see that. We have ourselves a Grogu from The Mandalorian. That's an awesome piece. And what would you call, because it's all green.
That's a monochrome piece. That's basically Copic, whatever you want to pronounce it, background with graphite pencil overlay.
Wow. Pencil overlay. And I don't know if you can see it very well above, so we'll put it here for now. That's a lot better shot, not as glare.
There's also a little white charcoal mixed in there for the high.
Such a cool piece. It's you know, that you use different things. There are different approaches at it, but it's still so neat.
Thank you.
Next one up here, we have ourselves a Homer.
Yes.
And that one looks more markers, if I had to guess.
Yeah, that is markers.
In a wide range of styles here. You know, we got super realistic, and then you've got the original Simpsons art style. So that's cool to see a range of stuff as well.
Yeah, and that's what I was aiming for all along, to kind of give everyone watching the kind of range that I can do.
Absolutely. We have ourselves a James Bond here,
just graphite pencil.
That's just graphite pencil?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I feel like it's glared. There's so much detail in that. And that's Sean Connery.
Yes.
Yeah, from, is that one, Dr. No?
Yes.
That is
the
Dr.
worst
no.
thing that ever wants to hear is, who's that supposed to be? And I've gotten that many times in my early years. And so, yeah, if you could recognize it right off the bat, then I'm doing something good.
Yeah, I mean, I knew, as soon as I flipped through them, when we first got them, I knew exactly who it was. I was just sitting here trying to think what movie that was from. And I thought it was Dr. No, but, I had to double check with you. So I didn't want to say something. And then like I was doing Seth Groves cards the other day, and I was like dead set. Like, I knew that his card was, what would I say? I think he said it was Sauron from Lord of the Rings. But he's like, that's the Witch King. And I was like, oh. I haven't seen those movies in so long. Some people are like, I watch them every year, like three times a year. And I'm like, man, I haven't seen the movies in so long. I think I've seen The Hobbit more than I have The Lord of the Rings. So yeah, but I know my my James Bonds. I do know those. I have them all, and I've been watching those for ever. So those are some of the ones I definitely do know. We have ourselves, I believe, Babe Ruth. I'm right there. I'm not a baseball person. Is that Babe Ruth?
Yes, Babe Ruth.
Okay. All right. Good. And
that's also just graphite.
Just graphite. Let's show this one off right here as well, because I hate that some of these cards here are not, they're just kind of glared. So much detail. It's so cool.
Of the pencil itself as well. That tends to happen. So,
right. And we've got several bright lights.
Yeah, the painted pieces usually come out a lot better.
Right. And they pop with the color too. When it's just the black and the white, and then the pencil themselves tend to shine. Have a hard time sometimes photographing the cards as well. So Yeah, that one. I thought I knew who it was. I've never been into baseball, and I'm not really. I don't know a whole lot about sports. I'm always been like Star Wars and movies and stuff like that. So, you know, I feel good. What you cut out a little? What'd you say?
I said I've always been a little bit of both.
Yeah, yeah. My dad has been too. Marty, he knows his sports and he knows his movies and especially his comics. I know movies. I know Star Wars mainly and some other random stuff there, James Bond. But my other thing is cars, so I'm not. I gotta like pick two. I can't really this brain can't hold more than that. It's two subjects. You know what I mean? We'll move on. We have ourselves a Deadpool, very unmistakable.
Right.
I mean,
I thought it was actually.
You thought it was what?
I thought it was Spider-Man. Actually, just kidding.
Yeah, Spider-Man. What's his name? Deathstroke. We're just watching the show. Yeah, I think they ripped off Deathstroke. Yeah, Wade. Was it Wade? What's his name?
Slade,
and then Wade. Yeah. That's right. Ourselves a Hulk, and this is from the MCU. That's what's his name, Mark Ruffalo.
Mm-hmm.
That's his version of the Hulk. It's a very good Hulk there. What was the style on this one? What was used on that one?
Actually, marker and graphite together.
Marker and graphite. When what was the Deadpool?
Deadpool was actually a little bit of everything. Graphite. Copic marker, some paint, and some white charcoal.
White charcoal. Cool. Mm-hmm. Good to know. And we have a awesome, awesome piece here. We have a Darth Maul, and my goodness, that looks just like Ray Park. I'm just saying. Like, yeah, if you just cover up part of his head, like, that's Ray Park. It's unmistakable. And if you would have had him over just a little bit, you could have even had his little earring up top up here. And it would have been 100% Ray Park.
Right.
Yeah, a little Star Wars fact for you guys that don't know that. If you look hard enough, they left Ray's earring in the top of his ear. And they said, that looks spacey enough. And they didn't make him take it out. So everybody knows that that is an actual earring in his ear.
I knew a little bit about.
What's that?
That I knew about.
Did you know that? Oh, that's awesome. Awesome. What did you use? What did you do with Ray's ear? Is that one acrylic?
That's actually kind of like the Deadpool. It's kind of a mix of everything, mixed media. Copic, the paints, white charcoal, markers, you know. A little bit of polychromos.
I don't know that last word you use there. Poly what?
It's basically the color pencils. It's everybody, it's polychromos.
All right, that one's new to me. It's good to know, though. Some people, like I myself, don't know these terms.
Well, I didn't, come across them probably for, I would say, a year ago. Found out about them, and they're real easy to blend, and they don't leave kind of like a chalky residue look to them. So it makes it more smooth.
That's good to know. I doubt I'll ever get into art. I'm not going to say I'm too old for it because I'm definitely not. You can always start a new hobby, but every time I try to draw something, it kills me. It's like I don't get one line right, and I'm like, gotta erase the whole thing. It's like stresses me out. I know art's not supposed to stress you. It's supposed to be like fun. It stresses me out.
Calm.
And I just try to draw a simple circle, and I'm like stressed.
Right. I've been there. I've been.
Yeah. Not for me. next up here, we have a Beast Boy from Teen Titans Go. That is odd. I love it, but it's odd. what was the choice behind this one? I need to hear that one.
My thing is my daughter and I like to watch that, and that was one of our favorite characters. So he's like, Dad, can you throw in one of those for me? You know, just so that I can be kind of represented in a way. She's 9.
I got you.
So I just threw that in there along with the Homer and the other one that you'll saw.
It's kind of funny. Gabe actually likes that show too.
Yeah. I don't know why. It's just funny.
I have seen quite a bit. I think my favorite episode is the one where they like, Gabe, what's the one like the night begins to shine episode? What's it called? Oh, he says the episode was called The Night Begins to Shine, where they have like the whole music video, the synth wave stuff. Like, I love that one. I don't know why.
Yep. I've seen that. We have that.
Gabe says they made a part two of it as well.
Yeah, they did. Just recently. So,
oh, really? I have to watch that one then. We have another a cartoon here, and it is Peter from Family Guy, Peter Griffin. And I will move this one back real quick.
Shut up, Meg.
What?
Shut up, Meg.
Okay. We have ourselves a Thanos. That is a wicked looking Thanos. What's the explain that one for me here? Color seems to pop a little bit better on this table.
Yeah, that is a mixed bag as well. Markers, paints, pencil. Just kind of like the Darth Maul and the other one.
Mm-hmm. Got ourselves a Admiral Thrawn here. Such a cool Thrawn. Nobody really knows Thrawn all that much. We don't see anybody ever paint Thrawn. I guess because they're not real fans. They don't watch the Clone Wars and Rebels. I will preach it until I die. And I'm sure people on this show are tired of me talking about it, but you got to watch Clone Wars and Rebels.
And eventually he's going to be live action, and that's when everything will go crazy.
He will. And they're going to be like, who's this guy? Why is he blue? Well, if you would have watched, you know, Clone Wars and Rebels, you would know.
Well, they got a little hint of it on Mandalorian season 2.
Yes, they did. Yes, they did. Most people watching The Mandalorian, if you've never seen it, are like, who's Ahsoka and why is she so special? Why are people freaking out about it? Well, you would know.
Yes.
Yeah, you would know if you watched the show. I'm just saying. And it's not a kid's show. Speaking of the devil, look at that right there.
Yes.
That is a Rosario Dawson Ahsoka.
Mm-hmm.
That is money. Absolutely. I love it. Big Star Wars guy, if you can't tell.
Oh, yeah, me too.
We have ourselves a Clone Wars Obi-Wan, and this is not the 2003 Clone Wars. This is the Clone Wars that I talk about all the time, but if you have seen the regular Clone Wars and Rebels and you want a little bit more, watch the 2003 because there's a lot of other stuff in there. They may not consider it canon, but there's a lot of cool stuff in there, like why General Grievous coughs all the time and, you know, why the ARC troopers are the ARC troopers and what planet Kit Fisto is from that you don't ever see in the regular Clone Wars. So kind of cool stuff there. And what are you said this Obi-Wan here is monochrome as well? Is that what you said earlier?
Yeah, just a Copic marker and a pencil overlay.
And you can say it how you want to say it. And I've heard Copic. I've heard alcohol markers.
I've heard about.
You know, some people don't like to pay for Copics. Copics.
They're very expensive. Or, comparable markers. Sometimes when you want to do the best work possible, you got to go with the champ there.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, same goes for any kind of colored pencil. I mean, you don't buy the good ones, and sometimes they just don't stick to them. You know, can't blend them or whatever. So we have ourselves a Leia that Carrie Fisher is phenomenal. I'll use dad's word now. And my word, fantastic.
Thank you.
That's awesome. It's this one deserves, let's throw this right here. Hopefully you get a little bit better zoom on that one. That's stunning. Like there's no, that looks like a picture. It looks like you traced a picture. I know you didn't, because these cards have black on the back. So he can't. So everybody out there knows he cannot trace that. That's awesome.
Thank you.
And that one is, I guess, a monochrome as well. Same style?
Right, that you have there.
Yeah, these three here on the bottom. And last but not least, we have ourselves an Iron Man. And
that was all paint.
All paint.
Mm-hmm.
All paint. That one is awesome as well. And I have a quick question for you. Do you see? Could you imagine anybody else portraying Iron Man? Like when you think of Iron Man, who do you think of?
I've actually thought of that. A couple of weeks. No, you can't really picture anybody else in.
RDJ is it? Yeah. Like even like the cartoons they do. Like it's RDJ. It's not the same voice actor, but that's who it is.
Right.
Like, I think, like, yeah, even the new comics or whatever, it's RDJ. Like, you can't, like, when you think of Thor, who do you think of? Hemsworth. Right? I couldn't imagine anybody else being Thor.
Hopefully, like, when you think of Batman,
you do what now?
Hopefully that doesn't bite him in the butt as far as them trying to get other roles, you know?
I don't think so. He's got quite a good variety of roles, but I think his big one's always going to be that. Just like, you know, RDJ's had a lot of roles too, and he makes a really, really awesome Sherlock Holmes. I love those Sherlock Holmes movies he made, and I hope they finish the third one. And he's just broad spectrum there, and I think Hemsworth does too, and I think Chris Evans does too.
Yeah.
But they'll always be... When you think of Cap, you think of Iron Man, you think of Thor, it'll always be who that is. So, that's just me. I'm just saying.
I agree.
So, we'll go on to some more questions here while we got the time here. Have you ever drawn Watto?
I actually have, yeah, for an official Topps series. I don't remember exactly when it was. Probably dating back to 2017. I was exploring all of
So you drew you drew an official top set Watto for a sketch card and turned it in.
Yeah.
I'm gonna have to find it now. I'm on the hunt for, if anybody's watching this, I doubt it, but if anybody's watching this and has Gerry Garcia's Watto, hit me up. I need it. I'm gonna start an official Watto collection for no reason.
Yeah. If you track it down, let me know, because I don't even think I have saved them.
Yeah, we'll see a picture of it. I doubt I'm ever going to find that, because it could have been in China for all we know. You know,
true.
Those things go everywhere. We don't really know where they're at, but you know, I hope I find it actually. So I'm gonna start at like a, you know, people do like. Are you on any of the Facebook groups? They do like dedicated collections to just like, you know, like Gonk droids or like BB-8 or something. I'm gonna like buy all the Wattos.
Yeah, there's a lot of people that. There are a lot of people that have a focus.
That's Yoda. What I was looking for.
Yeah.
Yeah. My collection, like, I've got quite a bit of. Yeah, I've got quite a bit of Star Wars cards, and I don't actually focus anything. I'm like, oh, that's cool. Like these here, I just be like, I don't really have a focus.
Or another focus would be, you know, specific artists themselves.
Yeah, I do like collecting from artists, especially ones that we. Yeah, I like collecting from artists, especially ones that we do on the show, to support their work. And like I said, I hit you up earlier and I was saying, you know, I need to get me an official one from you. I'd rather pay you than I would some eBay scalper. I hate to say that, but it is what it is. So next question here: how did you get in with Topps?
I was doing some Major League Baseball work, and I've always been drawing Star Wars since I could remember. And a artist friend of mine announced that he was a part of the set, or how he got into that. And he had, through a mutual friend, I tracked them down and said, who do I need to talk to? They, of course, you know, said basically like we did, just contact them, show them your online portfolio, and just wait and see. And that's what I did. Maybe sent it in, and I would say 2 weeks later, got a call and set me up for my very first set. And that was Journey to the Last Jedi in 2000. Okay.
All right. See, I like to ask this question for people that are, we have some people that are in, you know, getting into art or have been doing art for a while, but are just kind of doing it on the side or as a hobby. And I don't remember who it was. It was someone we found on Instagram who was not doing it with anybody, just doing it on the side as something he liked to do. And I was trying to, I was saying, you know, watch a few of the episodes that I've done and they'll explain what they've done to get in with Topps and stuff like that. So some people like that, you know, it's a good question for.
I've had folks request, you know, who's the art director, this and that. And I said, well, you know, it changes all the time, really, to be honest. So the best bet is always to go to the main site and just contact them. You know, that's not going to hurt. You know,
right.
And go through the general, emails. And then, you know, if they like what they see, then they'll contact
them. Yeah, just give them a good portfolio of a broad variety. If you're trying to do Star Wars, you're trying to do what, Rittenhouse, or what's the other one? What's the Marvel one?
Upper Deck?
What it was. Upper Deck, that's the one, yeah. You know, just send them a good portfolio of cards.
And that's what I was trying to bring to you guys there. Kind of like a portfolio, if you will.
Right, a good variety. And you know, I may have asked it early, but what was your, you know, what was your I guess, reasoning behind doing such a broad, just to do it, just because you can, or?
Yeah, just,
you
know,
what made you choose what you had here?
That was kind of harder. I wanted, around that time was the last episode of Mando Series 2, so I did the Grogu and Ahsoka from that. Always been a big baseball fan, and I figure a Universal player, which was Babe Ruth, everybody tends to know who that is, so as well as Sean Connery, he passed just before I did the cover. I kind of wanted to be current, as well as, you know, things that I like.
That's actually a lot of cool reasoning. we ask a lot of artists these different things, and some of them are like, because you gave me free reign, so I just did what was on, you know, on my mind or what my childhood was, and you know, you did what was current and what, you know, you were kind of into at the time, or what you mm-hmm. like. Is mm-hmm. we always like to hear that, and you know, I wouldn't ever want to do like a set or series. I say that, but I like to let artists do their free whatever you feel mm-hmm. like, because it always seems to be better that way, I guess, right. To me.
But you also have to consider the end user as well. If you do everything that you like, you know, there's chances that they won't appreciate as much as if it's something that they and is hot at the time. That
for sure, yeah. I think with like a set or with like commissions, absolutely. But we're random here, and these are people getting these for free, so they don't really have a whole lot to complain about. And getting any of these, you'd be crazy to complain about anything. I don't like, if you're gonna complain, send it back. I want it. That's all right. I'm saying. I want it. All right. Well, I got one last question for you before we do some plugs. Prequels, originals, or sequels?
I gotta go originals, though. I love the prequels more than most, I should say.
Most people do. Go with originals.
Yeah. Star Wars to me is Star Wars.
Yeah, I will say sequels. I'm sorry. I do that every time. I will say prequels for me just because I love the clones, and I love watching more Jedi than just one. But I do love the stories and the original, the originality of the originals. I like how that is where everything started. The sequels should have never existed. I'm sorry.
But here's my thought. If, let's say you like a TV show. Let's say you're a big fan of Friends. Not everyone's going to be a winner. But you still love the show, right? So for me, that's the way I look at Star Wars. You know, not every film is the best, but, you know, it's that world. And I fell in love with that when I was 4 years old, when the first movie came in. So it's been in my life all this time. So anytime they add to it, I love it. TV shows, whatever. You give me all you got.
I'll be honest with you. I know you're still talking, but I think my thing died. That's not good. Like mid-interview? Hang on. Wait. Oh, there you go. Okay.
I lost off. Okay, go.
Yeah, can you hear me now? Yeah, my earpiece here just died. I know you said all that, and it's okay. I may not have heard you, but the video did, and I will go back and listen to it at some point. So I apologize for that. I saw you talking, and I could hear you back there on the – on the thing there. So I like that they were Star Wars, and I like that they added some more stuff to it. I just think that there was a lot that could have been done a little better, and just to me, I don't know. I'm a diehard fan, but
in hindsight, yeah, there's some things they could have done a lot.
I think the biggest thing they could have done was stick with one director and one vision.
That's true. I agree with that.
They didn't, and they got a guy in the middle movie that screwed it up and did it on purpose, because he openly said, you know, I did it because I wanted to.
Mm-hmm.
That's not Star Wars, man. So, no, I don't know. Let's plug your Instagram and your Facebook or wherever people can reach you at. Well, so throw out some plugs here for us. So if you got a website, especially?
I have a website, but it's under construction. I'll give you my Instagram and Facebook. You can friend me up. I don't have a page on Facebook itself. Just my regular profile, which is Gerry Garcia Jr. with an X. Instagram would be Garcia Artworks, two A's in the middle. So GarciaArtwor. You can find me there and give me a like.
Which are you more active on?
Instagram.
Instagram, okay. You know, a lot of people are this or that and never both. So I like to ask that as well. So people may go on Facebook and message you and you may not see it I messaged you and you might not have seen it for a couple hours. Whereas if you're on Instagram, if you have notifications for Instagram, it may pop up immediately. So just so people know, I wanted to ask that as well. So,
anything I post on Instagram, I automatically post on Facebook.
Gotcha. So, are you taking any commissions in case anybody wants to know?
And I have a list. It's only waiting time is only about a few weeks. We just started a new one last weekend. So, I don't have any problem taking any more commissions. It's not a long wait right now. Hopefully, you know, I can knock these out. Everybody can be happy with the timing. But it's never any more than 6 months or so.
That's good. I mean, it's what you do for a living. And, you know, I hope people do watch this and hit you up. And even if they watch it 6 months from now, I hope that you've got a free spot for somebody or a year from now and they love your artwork. You may not be able to win a card, but he's awesome to deal with. And I'm looking to get a commission as well. And, hey, well, you get to know him better. I'm just saying.
Yeah, that'd be great. And I appreciate this platform.
Absolutely. Well, it's been fun. I thank you for being on here with us, and I sure hope that everyone enjoyed it as much as I did and enjoy these awesome cards, because I don't know how you couldn't love these things. I'm just saying.
Super sick work here from Gerry Garcia. My goodness, what a bunch of awesome cards and an awesome interview. The guy was really nice. And hopefully you guys enjoyed the interview from him. Hit him up. Make sure you, if you want any work from him, he is taking commissions right now. Maybe. Hopefully so. Gabe, what's your favorite card here?
Darth Maul.
Darth Maul, why?
Well, one, it looks like Ray Park. We met at Ray Park. And I love the detail on it.
Tons of detail there. It looks especially on just on the horns. Ray Park. That's crazy. Crazy good. We met Ray Park. Ray Park stole Gabe's phone. We took a really awkward picture. Gabe did not do a superhero pose, and I was like halfway through it.
I was not aware we were actually going to do a superhero.
Yeah, I was like halfway through it. It was awkward. Ray Park was really cool though. Hopefully we get to meet him again, and maybe he'll remember us. I'm not sure. My favorite would have to be Obi-Wan.
I feel like he will.
Just for the fact that he did a Clone Wars Obi-Wan, like early on Clone Wars Obi-Wan. That's really cool. Nobody ever watches the show, and nobody ever does any art from it.
Fair enough.
Super cool dude. Really.
Yeah.
We'll just leave these out here like this.
Love the different art styles that you can do.
Yeah, we'll just leave these out here like this. And before everybody leaves, we have a few things to say. Number one, we are going to be at Cowtown Comic-Con. This is the second annual Cowtown Comic-Con at the Hearst Conference Center in Hearst, Texas. That is Saturday and Sunday, July 24th and 25th, 2021. That is only like 2 months away. Actually, less than 2 months away. Admission is only $10. Kids under 12 are free. This is put on by our good buddy Chris Hayes and Pastime Comics. I don't really know what else to say about it, but it's a really cool show. The first one was actually really for their first annual during all the craziness. It was a good show, and this one is supposed to be like four times as big. So if you're wanting to go to a cool show out in Dallas, this is one that was going to be awesome. We're going to be there. We're going to have all of our friends are going to be there. All the people we normally do stuff with are going to be there as well. So make sure if you're in the area, you do come out and see us, because I know we have some, quite a few viewers out in the Dallas area and surrounding areas, and we've never met you. So if you want to come to a con, come to this one. It's cheap and convenient, and if you want to come meet us, come swing by and say, hey, we'd love to meet you. Other than that, make sure that you like the video, you subscribe, and you hit the notification bell if you want to get entered to win any of these cards from Gerry Garcia, which hopefully you know how to by now. If you don't, make sure you click the first link in the description. Click the link, fill it out. It's a simple, easy landing page form. Make sure it's accurate, because all we have to do is, if you win, we'll just mail it right to you, and we don't have to harass you, because we hate harassing people. Other than that, Gabe, any last words about Gambit, Gerry Garcia, or Cowtown?
No. Goodbye.
Whoa. Guardians. Looks like we're dealing with the Vex today. Ding 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 ding